Hello, everyone, and welcome to my darling's distractions. My name is Luke, and I am joined, as always, by my lovely wife, Deb.
Hi, Luke.
Hi, Deb. I just realized I don't know what episode this is. What'd you say? This is maybe episode, like, 19?
Yeah, 18 or 19, because we're definitely not at 20 yet.
Nope, not at 20 yet. Deb, I've got good news and bad news.
Oh.
Good news is we are starting off technically season number 2 of My Darling's Distractions.
Yes.
So congratulations to us and thank you to everybody who's listened to even one episode.
Mm-hmm.
I want to remind people.
Time to celebrate.
Yeah, if you're a fan and want to celebrate with us, if you reach out to Deb or I on Deb or me on social media, we can get you a magnet or a pin.
Yeah, we've got a box of those sitting around. Mm-hmm. So if you want it, here it is.
Yep.
You can have it.
Just ask for it.
But you better hurry because they're going fast.
Yeah.
You better hurry because it may not last.
May not last. Yeah. Okay, so that was the good news.
Okay,
yeah. Bad news is we're going to start off season 2 with correcting ourselves.
Ah, yes. It's true. There was an unfortunate discovery at the end of our last episode. I'm not unfortunate, just funny.
It's just...
Yeah. Yep. Luke was like, you want to listen to some of our voicemails? So I did, and I discovered one from my... friend and roommate Stacy.
Mm-hmm. College roommate
Stacy, and her voicemail said you should do one for your 15th anniversary about how you guys met.
Mm-hmm.
And tell your story of just how you began, and it was the exact episode idea that I had just had and that we just recorded.
Right. So Stacy had sent this in before the events, before our last recording. So we should have included it, but Deb and I just kind of had a miscommunication. So we're going to start off throwing that here at the top of the episode. Are you ready, Deb?
Yes. Thank you, Stacy, for your voicemail. Here it is.
Hey, Luke and Deb, it's Stace. I have a lot of comments about the show, but I normally just text you. But I would like to say my favorite shows were the time travel episode, because I like time travel movies too, and also the Survivor episode, except I was kind of disappointed, Deb, in some of your guys' answers. My boys love listening with me right now. My boy is shouting from the background that I should request an American Ninja Warrior episode. But I called in to request a special Luke and Deb edition, 15th anniversary edition of like early relationship stuff, because I was there and it was fun and I'd love to travel back for that. So that's all I have. Love your podcast, faithful listener. And yeah, we'll hope to see you soon. Bye.
That was great.
Yes. Thank you, Stacy. And thank you for coming up with that idea so strongly that it apparently affected Deb. Like,
we were communicating.
That's right, across the distance.
I'm sure it happens more often than we realize. Mm-hmm. A couple different things, though. You don't know how many people have been disappointed with my Survivor answers.
Really? Has that been a common... That's been coming up with people.
Huh? I just heard it this week from another friend from college, actually. Yeah. She was like... yelling at the radio of like, you know, why don't you know these Jeff Probst quotes?
Yeah, that's a good
question. It's true. That was, I missed that one by a mile a few times. Also, how hard would an American Ninja Warrior episode be?
So, neither you nor I really watched that show. And so it would be very difficult to put together anything. I mean, from what I gather on the periphery, is that people, like, there's fandoms that follow, like, different athletes. And, like, you see them maybe more than once. It's just so bizarre because I just don't know anything about it. The closest reference I would have would be like an old 1990s or 1980s American Gladiators.
Yeah, I mean, it's like American Gladiators, right?
But you don't have like Siren or...
Right.
I don't know. Boy, that was short-lived. I can't think of any other.
Who are the other ones?
Siren.
There was like Titan or...
Titan was probably...
Was that one?
That might have been from the relaunch.
Oh.
The Wolf was from the relaunch. I don't know.
The Wolf. I don't know that one.
I just now realized how few American Gladiators
I can name. What were their names? I mean, it was like Saturday morning primetime American Gladiators.
Anyway, so I would have to...
Yeah. I can think of like four different people that would be rattling them off right now.
Yeah. So if we did an American Ninja Warrior, it would have to be like... me comparing what it is now to what I was used to growing up.
Well, that's the thing is every time I watch it, it's a different group of people competing. So I have to imagine that there's some kind of bracket, like tourney bracket, probably. Don't you think? Like if Joe makes, you know, beats everybody, does he get some kind of championship at the end of the season?
I don't know.
Is it like Survivor?
No. I have no idea.
I think it's... I have no idea either.
No idea. No. Yeah, someday we can... If I found myself really enjoying that show and really getting into it, we could try.
Yeah, we could.
So, another thing I wanted to talk about, Deb, is we are recording a little bit late because last weekend we were busy. We were up in... in Sioux Falls doing a... we were at Siouxpercon.
Our first comic book convention.
That's right. Yeah. No, it's not my first convention, but yes, my first comic book convention.
What was another convention that you went to?
I went to Tricon, a board game convention.
Oh, yeah, so, that's right. Yeah,
But no, this was very... it was really fun. So I wanted to ask you a couple of things about it, Deb. First of all, what were some of your highlights from Siouxpercon this last weekend?
I think just the highlight of the whole family being together and experiencing that with the kids. There was a fun VR area, game set up, and everybody except you.
Yeah, no, I did not play Batman VR like you guys.
Yeah, all of us got a chance to put on the headset.
There was a line forming behind us. It was one of those things where like all four of you had a chance to play it, and there was a group of a couple people waiting to play as they watched our entire family fail. Yeah, we couldn't do it.
Yeah, like,
supposed to get into a sewer, and we had to... we figured out how to use a grappling hook to grab a hook, but I had no idea what to do with
it. And then the kids were like, "Mom, grab your flashlight or whatever from your utility belt." So I did, and then I didn't know how to like drop it and disarm it. Like, it really could have been fun if we could have figured out how to get past that grate. Yeah, I mean, it was... anyway.
Yeah. So we did some PlayStation VR at the video game section of
that was fun. Of the convention. We made our way around to all of the booths, like just really
just kind of looking.
Yeah.
Gave the kids a few dollars to spend, and that, which is fun because there's lots of neat things that people bring. You know, homemade things that are comic book adjacent.
So. Yeah. So this was kind of funny. I found this one booth that was selling earrings. They were like Star Wars earrings.
Right.
And I made the comment that if they would have had Jurassic Park earrings, I would have. But so I did find those some Star Wars earrings that I thought about getting. That would be so nerdy to wear Star Wars earrings around, don't you think?
Yeah, it's just like wearing like a Star Wars...
I mean, but I would do it. I would do it.
Yeah.
You
specifically asked me, says, "Is this something I could wear to a premiere?"
Yeah.
And that's about the only reason, like,
yeah,
you buy a set of earrings just to watch Star Wars in your Star Wars earrings.
That's... I would do that.
We've done that enough. You might get enough uses out of them.
Yeah. But the thing is, so I picked out a pair that I liked and I like took it to the gal to purchase and she said cash only.
Oh, that's right. There was a lot of that. I imagine.
And I said, I was just straight up, I didn't even feel bad. I was just like, "Oh, okay, sorry." Because come on.
Well, I mean, I understand because I felt really guilty. Because our middle daughter picked out something that was a dollar. And it was from a booth where they would take credit cards, but I charged them a dollar. And I'm pretty sure that they get charged a percentage. And there's like a flat, maybe like $3 or $2 charge just to use credit cards.
The swiper. Yeah. And we were like, kids, does anybody else want something?
I know. We looked at everybody. We just couldn't...
nobody wanted anything else. So. They really didn't have a lot of merchandise when I looked around, though. Did you notice that?
It was pretty small booth. But maybe I'm bearing the lead a little bit because we specifically went there because Miles from Sioux Falls.
Oh, yeah. Our friend Miles from Sioux Falls.
Had a booth. He had a booth. He was part of a larger group. Empire Comic Press is the group he's with. Yeah, mm-hmm. I tried to look him up online. So, yeah, he has been the writer on a new comic book series called Robot Dance Club.
Yes. He let us read a little bit of the first issue a couple months back.
Yeah,
and that was really great.
So, Deb, can I what I'd like to do to show off the premise is I'd like to, like, in a movie voice, read that first little blurb.
I mean, it's the most excellent writing in a comic book I've ever read.
Now, Deb, to be fair, how many comic books have you read?
Well, okay, so this is going to, you're probably going to laugh, but I read a ton of Archie comics when I was growing up. Like, a ton.
Even better than Archie comics.
Oh, yeah. This was like a novel.
Sure. Okay. So while we were there, we picked up issue number one, which is it's a monthly, I believe. I don't know.
We should ask. Monthly comic. That.
I think it says that. But anyway, we both that read it really enjoyed it.
Yes. Really enjoyed it the first time a couple months ago when we got to read a little bit.
A little bit of it, yeah.
And it was just really exciting to see the finished product.
Yeah. So, all right. So we got a signed copy. I'm going to get it out of its shrink wrap right now. That's a little bit of Foley work there. Okay. So we'll see. I'll see if I can read this in like my my movie theater voice. Maybe we can.
You were going to have me do the
some
reading.
Cool effects. I don't know. I kind of sound like a movie.
All right.
Guy.
You do it.
All right. The robots have won. That terrifying moment when humanity's creations acquired sentience is past. But mankind does not live in fear. The human race is not enslaved, destroyed, or wired up like batteries. It is simply ignored. The robots carry on. They build. They destroy. They continue. And of course, they dance.
Okay.
How was it? How was my reading?
I don't know. Can I
read
it now?
Yeah. Deb doesn't like when I do voices. It embarrasses her.
I just think, like, it doesn't sound normal. Like, yeah. It doesn't sound normal.
I'm reading in a voice. All right. Here's Deb's take two.
Okay. This is like maybe more like how you would read to a child.
Oh, okay.
Okay. The robots have won. That terrifying moment when humanity's creations acquired sentience is past. But mankind does not live in fear. The human race is not enslaved, destroyed, or wired up like batteries. It is simply ignored. The robots carry on, they build, they destroy, they continue, and of course, they dance.
So, who did it better? You let us know.
And we've just read the first page of
that's right.
The comic book that you're supposed to go and buy.
Yes, please do. Yeah, so, I don't know. This tells you how prepared I am. I don't even know how you would buy this because we bought it in person. But I imagine you could go to Empire Comic Press, go to their website, and I'm sure they have ways to...
Probably.
To buy it on there. I really don't know. But it's a monthly. We're really excited. We had a long discussion about kind of the lore. Like, we were trying to put together the lore of the world.
Mm-hmm.
Some big questions we had were about umbrella teleportation. And a bunch of stuff like that. So, anyway, go check that out. Just a disclaimer, Miles is our friend, and we're promoting his product, so... but please, go check it out. We really enjoyed it. Anyway, can I share some of my highlights from the Comic-Con?
Sure.
No, I'm sorry. From Supercon?
Yes.
I really enjoyed going around and looking at people in costume.
Mm-hmm.
I really enjoyed... I got a picture with one of the contestants of the cosplay competition.
Yeah, that was another highlight.
It was fun. She was dressed up like Nebula. So the kind of half cybernetic, half real, and her costume was very good.
It was really good. And
when she walked on the stage, like they all did, everybody who participated, she did like a Nebula walk.
And you're like, yes,
stage presence was very good.
Was on point.
Yeah.
And did she win something?
She did. She won some level prize. I can't remember what it was. Yeah. But yeah, that was really fun to see that. There was a lot of really neat. I was really impressed. There was a person dressed up like Nightmare from the Sega Dreamcast game Soul Calibur.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a throwback for me, but a great costume.
Oh, it was also intimidating.
Also great, presence on the stage. There was there was a lot of really...
And he didn't win anything. I wish he would have.
So disappointing. I wanted to get my picture with him, but he had already taken off his things. It looked very hot.
Yeah.
Yeah. So no, it was, that was a lot of fun. Also, so I have to say a thank you to Deb because I was going to go up with the kids, you know, the kids got in free. And so I was just going to go up me and the kids because it's not really Deb's thing. You were somewhat interested, but anyway, we all went up together. And there was a point where you guys, we'd probably been looking around for probably, what do you say, 2 hours, something like that.
I bet we were there for almost three.
Almost 3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And the kids were all kind of done.
Well, had, and hungry. We hadn't had lunch. Yeah,
hungry, and they kind of, I had asked, I said, if we go get lunch, do you guys want to come back? And they're like, oh, no, no, not really.
Yeah.
And so Deb graciously said, I'll take the kids. And you can stay here, and then you let me stay for another 3 hours while I just, like, really looked at some stuff. Like, I went and, like, really got a chance to look at some really cool things. They had the DeLorean there.
Yeah.
That was awesome to see. They had a guy who kind of does public relations as Batman, like, does, fundraising and does...
Did you talk to him?
I didn't, no. But he was there with another person was dressed up like Joker, and I think he was dressed up like the new Jared Leto Joker, like very like, and he was,
wait a second, Jared Leto or Joaquin Phoenix?
Oh, sorry, he was dressed up like the new Joaquin Phoenix Joker.
Okay,
so and he was like, he was interesting to watch walk around because he stayed in character the whole con, and like anytime you'd see him walk by, he was laughing. He had this set of teeth he kept pulling out of his pocket and holding.
Oh yeah, the chatter,
chattering teeth. Anyway, it was so it was just a lot of fun.
I agree. Yeah, and that's kind of why I went, because I, that was my hesitation about going with the kids, is I knew you would probably want to sit and maybe play a game or do something. So I decided I would go, and then I would be the backup plan if you wanted to stay longer.
Yeah, which is great. So, all right. So, Deb, to start off our second season, I have decided to quiz you and talk about a topic that has actually been suggested to us by Liz.
Oh, good.
So I'm going to introduce the topic and then we'll be able to listen to Liz's voicemail.
Okay.
So, Deb, I think this is a topic that will really have a lot of, we'll have a lot to both of us. Well, there'll be a lot for both of us to talk about.
Think, this topic. Good.
So, Deb, we are going to be talking about contemporary Christian music. Saddle up your horses!
Oh, no. Of the 1990s?
Yeah, specifically looking at some 80s, 90s, and some 2000s.
Oh, man. This should be good.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting to see.
Yes, some good memories, probably. Yeah,
so let's go ahead and listen to Liz's voicemail.
Hey, guys. I had another idea for a podcast, and I think this would appeal to many of your listeners. What if you did a Name That Tune with 90s and early 2000s? What do you call that decade? I don't know. What if you did a Name That Tune with 90s and 2000 Christian music? So put in a little Jars of Clay, DC Talk, Twyla Paris, Rich Mullins, Jeff Moore in the Distance, the Supertones, Petra. What's that? Oh man, what's that one song that I'll think of it later? It was real big. Anyway, that doesn't help at all.
Could be anything.
I thought that would be really funny if
I don't know. I'm assuming that Luke would get in on that fun. It'd be fun if you guys could play against each other sometime. Like, what if a third party organized a quiz for you guys sometime? That would be really fun. Something to consider. So, have a good night. Love you guys.
That's great. Yeah.
So, I won't play it here, but we got three more voicemails from Liz of her just naming 90s and early 2000s. By the way, Liz, the decade you're calling, you're thinking of,
we do have a name for that.
It's called the aughts.
Mm-hmm. It's the aughts.
So yeah, she go back three times with different, just naming different artists.
I like how she was like, and that one song that was really big. I don't know what it's called.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Luke, are we going to play each other?
No.
We're not going to versus.
No. Okay. Sorry. This was...
So, we should just say, hey, Liz, if you... Like, you could totally come up with a quiz for both of us. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Don't you think she could?
Yeah, sure. Just pick it. I mean, so here's a little look behind the curtain. I'll part the kimono just a bit. So what happens is I just think about things that I think Deb kind of likes and has a little bit of knowledge about, and then I just make up a random quiz. You guys will see today how random the quizzes can be.
nice.
Just about it. But yeah, so anybody, yeah, feel free. If you want to come up with a random quiz, we're very willing to be pitted against each other because we don't often get to do that. I usually get to sit with a lot of knowledge and make myself look really smart because I've done like, research before we start. But, yeah, feel free, anybody.
I'm not sure how the ins and outs of how that would work, but...
Yeah, well, we'd figure it out.
Let's give it a whirl.
Yeah, we figured it out. Deb, so I want to start with just a little conversation with you about contemporary Christian music.
Yeah.
What's, when you think of contemporary Christian music, what are some of the artists or songs that come to your mind, Deb?
The first and foremost group that comes to my mind is 4Him.
Now here we're taking a little bit of a flashback back to our boy bands.
Yes, that's true.
I would call 4Him a boy band because, they wrote their own music. I suppose, but they didn't dance, so I don't know.
Yeah, probably really no dancing.
But their name is the number 4 H-I-M, no spaces.
That's so great.
They definitely follow that formula.
They do. Yeah, I was crazy about 4Him. I knew all of their songs. Before long, I had all of their albums.
Right. But not crazy in like you would for a boy band way, because these guys, when they were
popular, they were
in their 50s,
they were, no,
40s.
Oh, no, Luke, 50s. That's way too old. 30s. Yeah, they were probably in their 30s.
Right, but you were
teenage. They're probably in their 50s now.
Okay.
But, or like early, maybe early 60s. But no, it wasn't like, you know, not that kind of crazy. Like I liked them or anything. Mm-hmm. There was one guy in the group, his name was Andy, and I just really liked his voice. Mm-hmm. And so anytime he would sing, I just thought it was really cool.
Sure.
And then there was another guy named Marty. I thought there was one song that he sang that was, his voice sounded really cool in it.
Okay.
But no, I just thought that I liked their music and I knew the words to almost all the songs.
Yeah.
All right. So 4Him, and then like if we're going into like the aughts, then I think another group that I kind of started to like that would be similar was Phillips Craig & Dean.
Ah, PCD. Yeah, I can't believe that they were popular in the 2000s. I suppose it was just maybe in the tail end of 99.
Yeah, and that's maybe just kind of when I caught on to it.
Yeah, maybe.
But so, Cademan's Call, remember them? Yeah. DC Talk. This is so funny to talk about all these groups. It's like memories. Flashback.
So for me,
Stephen Curtis Chapman.
That's right.
My friend Carly used to call him Stephen Curtis Crapman.
She didn't like his music? she just thought that was funny?
She just did that to, like, poke fun at our youth pastor because it was his favorite.
Oh, okay. Stephen Curtis Crapman. My experience, I had a lot of experience with contemporary Christian music. I think, one, because it was the thing that I could play at any time on any sound equipment around our house, and that was okay. Not all music was okay all the time. And two, because we had our satellite picked up ZTV, which I've briefly talked about before, but it was a only contemporary Christian music video, music videos.
Yeah.
Which there weren't a ton.
So right. I've kind of It was on loop.
Yeah, like, it was on loop.
The same 10.
Yeah, yeah, however many they had. But I really enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. And three, because my parents went to a lot of contemporary Christian artists' concerts.
They did.
Yeah, I remember one of my youngest memories of, I must have been maybe Griffin's age, or actually I was probably maybe five.
Yeah.
My parents went to a Carmen concert.
Oh, okay.
And I remember, yeah. Or maybe, I can't remember if it was Carmen, or I might be conflating a couple of different memories, but there was one concert where, like, we sat through the concert, or, you know, stood and sat through the concert, and there was a point in time where I just decided I didn't want to pay attention anymore, so I laid down on the stadium ground and just fell asleep below floor of the stadium. I was just laying down face first on the cement. Oh. I just remember, and then my parents carried me to the car afterwards, so, anyway, my parents went to a lot of those. Mm-hmm. We used to always go to a concert up in Spearfish called Hills Alive, which was a big Christian concert outdoors.
I feel like there are a lot of that kind of stuff in this area of the state, and I never had anything like that growing up.
I mean, every year we would go to some concert or a multiple. I mean, yeah, that was where I got really introduced. And, like, it was just a totally different feeling because I'd never really gone a place where you could buy the merchandise of a band or anything like that. So, yeah, I kind of got in. I remember the DC Talk Free at Last CD was maybe the first CD my family ever had. We got a CD, and that CD and a CD player. And, I listened to that CD a lot.
Yeah. I remember when I had, it wasn't my first job, but it was my second job at a sporting goods store.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite band for him, they were going to sing at this, there was a guy that was, I think he was running for president, but he was a Christian, and he had For Him sing it, like one of their appearances in the summer.
Well, in Iowa, that's the thing. You have a caucus, and so during the Iowa caucus,
That season, they have these, I don't even know what they're called, but things, like events. Mm-hmm. And so For Him was going to be at one of these events, and I asked, it was on a Saturday, and I was like, it's my favorite, I can't miss it.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't get the time off. My boss wouldn't let me go.
How many times had you ever asked for time off?
I mean, that's the thing. I wasn't in sports, and so I didn't even have a schedule that conflicted with work at all, and so that was really disappointing
for
me.
So you didn't go?
Nope, didn't go.
I would have called, I don't know, I wouldn't have called
in sick.
No,
you wouldn't have.
A different person would have called in sick.
Yeah.
Well, Deb, I feel like we could go on and on about different Christian groups.
And we will, probably.
And we will, probably. But we will get a chance to talk about them a little bit more. I'd like to figure out how much you know about Christian groups from the 90s and the aughts and maybe the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do that in a section that I'm calling Quiz Me, Baby.
Call it that too.
So Deb, I've come up with two different quizzes, and I really stretched my stretched my imagination on like how to quiz you, because they're like a name that tune I feel like would be so easy for you.
Okay.
Right? So there's a part of me that originally thought like, okay, I could quiz Deb by doing a B-sides quiz where I just play like some of the lesser known songs of maybe some artists.
Of an artist.
But I just thought, but then I decided,
like, how fun would that really be?
Right, right. You just hear songs that you don't really recognize.
Yeah.
So
we want to be able to sing along.
Yeah. So I've come up with a couple of quizzes, and we'll see how this goes.
Okay.
My first quiz, okay, let me preface it by saying this. A lot of contemporary Christian music groups come up with their group name based on some sort of connection to the Bible.
Okay.
I mean, they're a Christian group, so it makes kind of sense that they would have a name connected to the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did is I looked up some of the names of different contemporary Christian groups, and what I did was I tried to figure out what Bible verses their name might be referencing.
Oh, man.
So what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be reading a short section of scripture.
Okay.
And your job is to figure out which contemporary Christian
group my goodness.
Is this scripture referencing? Or is it, did the group kind of reference? Now, I thought it might be too easy. So what I did, I'm going to be reading these to you out of the King James Version.
Okay.
Specifically. Just because I thought I'd throw in a little bit of extra challenge. I think, Deb, you are going to do great at this.
Okay. All right.
So, Deb, I have 10 groups that it's going to be your job to figure out what group this is based on this passage of scripture.
Okay.
All right.
Quiz me, baby.
Number one.
Mm-hmm.
This is from 2 Corinthians 4:7. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us.
That's jars of clay.
Deb, you're correct. That's jars of clay.
That was nice probably job. The easiest one, huh?
That might be the easiest one. So carry me, I'm just a dead man lying on the carpet. Can't find a heartbeat. Make me breathe. Wanna be a new man. Tired of the old one. Off with the old plan. All right, Deb, very good. Okay.
Okay, good.
Any fond memories of Jars of Clay?
Yes, but you know what? It's also just bringing to mind a ton of other groups. Yeah, Jars of Clay. I feel like that was maybe the one that people, like it one of woke. My very first. Yeah, like,
it, oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, not even DC Talk. Like Jars of Clay might have been the first album that I listened to, like, okay. and really... learned, I don't know, maybe not, but okay. It just seems like I knew that one before DC Talk, I think.
For me, Jars of Clay, I just remember that it was like, well, the first time it broke big enough that like everybody kind of knew Jars of Clay.
Yeah. And I also want to say, I think I've seen Jars of Clay.
Oh, I think I have too.
We went, when I was growing up, my friends in the youth group, like we went to this amusement park in Ohio.
Mm-hmm.
And I always want to say King's Point, but it's not. Maybe it's King's Island.
Mm, okay.
And it's like a really famous amusement park. Big, like, like setting records big. And so I think that Jars of Clay was on their stage one time when we were there.
Okay.
And yeah. My youth pastor had taken us to go visit a college in Ohio, and then we would always go to King's Island, and I think that we saw Jars of Clay there.
Yeah, I think I saw them at like a combined concert with a lot of other artists. Probably did like two songs, but yeah. All right, good job, Deb.
Yep, thanks.
All right, number two. This is from Matthew 16, verse 18. And I say also unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it.
Oh, boy. Of course, all of these, I'm going to feel like I should know all of these.
I'm going to go ahead and tell you this. Some of these might be a little bit of a stretch because it's not like Jars of Clay was a pretty on-the-nose one. But some of these might be a little bit more abstract. It's just, where would maybe the idea of this come from in that verse?
Okay. The name, like, the band name that's coming to my mind is Casting Crowns, but it's not that.
Okay.
Wow. I don't know.
You're going to take a miss?
Yeah, I think I have to, because I'm just drawing a blank.
Okay. Deb.
Yeah.
The group is Petra.
Oh. Does Petra mean rock?
Petra means rock.
Oh, see, I never would have gotten that.
Oh, Deb, that group makes so much more sense when you realize that their name means rock. That's their whole thing. They were the Christian rock group.
They were the rock group.
Petra means rock. I think it was literally like the tagline to like their group.
Okay, nope. I never got that.
Oh, no. Oh, Deb, that's horrible. Do you have a new appreciation for the group Petra?
Well, no. I mean, because there were other rock groups.
Mm-hmm. They were one of the earlier ones. I know they've been around. 70s. I could be wrong.
There was another one that my...
Striper?
Yes. Yeah. That was the one that my youth pastor talked about.
Striper. Striper's great. If you want to have a good time, go on to Google and type in Striper, S-T-R. I think it's Y-P-E-R.
Uh-huh. I think so.
Yeah. They are a like 70s hair band, 70s, 80s hair band, but they were Christian. They kind of dressed up like bumblebees for some reason. Huh. But they sang, or go to YouTube and look up a song called To Hell With The Devil.
Okay.
It is intense.
I've heard it.
It's some really good screaming and it's so good. Anyway, no. Petra.
Okay.
Petra means rock.
Yeah, I never would have gotten that one.
Yeah, if you would have got that, or if you would have known that, would have made a big difference.
Uh-huh.
Okay. All right, Deb. Number two.
Petra. I remember Liz getting a Petra album.
Okay.
Like, I think it was a tape.
Yeah.
I don't know. Might have been a CD, but I remember her getting a Petra album, and I thought, why? Like, why did she get Petra? But then of course, we listened to it together because we drove the same car. And I started to like it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Deb, we're going to keep moving here.
Okay.
We've got two quizzes to get through.
I know.
All right. Deb, question number three. This is from 1 Corinthians 15, verse 4.
Okay.
And that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day, according to the scriptures.
Jeff Moore in the distance. No.
Is that your guess, Deb?
No.
Okay.
I don't know. This is horrible.
It's all right. You gonna take a miss on number three?
Yeah.
All right. The correct answer is third day.
Oh. Okay. I wanna sing a song for you. I know for you I wanna sing a song. And I wanna lift my voice to heaven. And listen to Does that kind of make sense? Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and I do know who they are.
Okay. All right. So, all right. Maybe just
not one of my favorites.
No. Some of these were more towards like the ones that were easier to make a quiz about. Not necessarily the ones that you necessarily.
No, that's okay.
With.
But I have definitely heard their stuff in college more.
Yeah, I think they were an aughts band.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry, Deb. That's a miss on three.
Oh, that's two that I've missed.
All right. Here we go.
Okay.
This is question number four, I believe.
Okay.
This is from James 5:18. What band is this referencing? And he prayed again, and the heavens gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit.
Sixpence None the Richer.
Sixpence None the Richer. Explain your answer. Show your work, Deb.
Show your... Are they... They're not... Are they... A Christian group?
We'll find out.
I feel like for some reason they were, but then I want to say they're totally not.
They're totally not. Okay.
Anyway, that's not a serious answer.
All right. What's your serious answer,
Dan? Plum.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
I'm right. Aren't I?
That's a good guess.
Yep.
You're incorrect.
Oh.
Deb, the correct answer to number four is PFR.
Oh. What does that even stand for?
Pray for rain.
Okay.
Did you know that?
No.
Okay.
No.
It's, all right. Man, Deb.
I know.
So, there's like misconnections. I feel like these are really good. It's just not connected.
They are
what
really
you know.
Good. We never rested, never gave her a choice. We just barked out commands. Sit, stand, don't bite. Stop licking my hands. Those days are gone now. I wish Goldie could come out and play. They're really good.
So,
and well thought out.
So PFR used to be called Pray for Rain, but then they got sued, or there was an attempt at suing them from another group called Pray for Rain that did like soundtrack music.
Oh.
So they switched to
just PFR.
Yeah.
Okay.
And do you know they're a Minnesota band?
Oh, okay. No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, PFR, I was a big fan.
I don't think I could even name one of their songs.
Goldie's Last Day.
I've heard you say that before, but
Yeah, so maybe not in your wheelhouse.
No.
Okay, no, that's a mess. All right, Deb, number five.
Okay.
Let's get you back on the back of the wagon.
I already know my guess for number five.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I'm just
at that point where
I'm going to throw it out there, Deb, and just save you by this. Sixpence None the Richer is not on here.
Mm.
But I wanted them to be because that name sounds like, okay, where did that come from?
Yeah.
It comes from a C.S. Lewis quote in Mere Christianity, I believe.
Oh.
Where C.S. Lewis mentions how this boy, the father gives the son some money, and the son takes that money and buys the father something. And the father is like, sixpence, that's not much money, but I'm none the richer. Like, that exchange didn't bring him any, because it was his to begin with, his money to begin with. And they talk about how, as a group, like that idea, like to like, you know, use your abilities for God, like you're just bringing back what's already his, you know. It's a little, we're bringing back just a little bit, and he's none the richer for it because it's his to begin with.
Okay.
Anyway.
Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah.
So they do have some Christian.
I believe so.
Root.
Yeah. Hmm. So anyway.
I thought so, but I wasn't sure because didn't they sing Kiss Me?
Kiss Me.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
But
I mean, we know
Christians
don't sing about
that's
kissing.
Not it. Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. All right, Jeb, all right, Deb, we're going to jump on to number five. This is from Genesis 3:23.
Okay.
Therefore, the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken.
Audio adrenaline.
Cool.
I'm just
What makes you think audio adrenaline, Deb?
Because that was the next group name I thought of.
Okay, cool.
No reason, Luke.
All right.
No reason.
Deb, that's wrong.
I know.
Deb, the correct answer is out of Eden.
Oh, okay, yeah, I see that. These are really good clues, okay.
Right.
But... I mean,
he literally says, it says he sent him forth from the Garden of Eden.
Out of Eden.
Yes.
Okay. I'm realizing that I know quite a few quite a few artists.
Okay.
But
not as many groups,
bands.
Huh?
See, groups.
Now, I definitely knew more groups than artists, I feel like, but.
Yeah,
okay. So I will give you a heads up.
Yeah.
Any person who's just a single artist and like their name of their group is like Stephen Curtis Chapman, it's not going to be in here.
Yeah, I realize that.
Okay, yeah. All right, Deb, we're on to number six.
Okay.
This is from Matthew 7, verse 3.
Okay.
And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considereth not the beam that is in thine own eye? King James really coming through.
Yeah,
on
that one's
verse.
Cool. It's something about judgment. Brother's keeper.
So it says, I'll read it again.
Okay.
And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but considerest not the beam that is in thine own eye?
Yeah.
Okay.
Was I off? Is that why you read it again?
Just giving you more information.
Okay. Like, don't judge someone else. When you haven't even looked at yourself.
Okay.
Audio adrenaline.
You are incorrect. This might be the worst quiz
this
you've ever had.
This is the worst I've ever done.
Deb, the correct answer is plank eye.
It's difficult to say goodbye after only one life, and rain will fall down, replenishing all of our broken dreams. And this burning tree.
Oh, okay.
Do you not know Plank Eye?
I mean,
you know of them.
I think I've heard, like, I might even be able to, like, see their album art.
Sure.
But.
Sure.
Nope.
You couldn't name it.
Can't name anything.
Okay. I mean, does that kind of make sense?
That was really
sense,
good clue.
Oh.
Yes. It was really good. It's falling so flat
okay.
on me, though.
All right, Deb. All right. hopefully maybe somebody out somebody's, there listening
somebody's
is like,
having
oh,
fun.
These are right on. All
right. Somebody's getting them all.
All right, let's drudge through the rest of this quiz.
No, it's all good. Right. It really
all right,
is.
Deb, I think we're on to number 7. This is from Revelation chapter 4, verses 10 through 11.
Okay.
The 24 elders fall The 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne and worshipped him that liveth forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created.
Casting crowns.
Deb, you are correct.
Yes.
Nice.
You never win, but the voice of truth tells me a different story. The voice of truth says, do not be afraid. And the voice of truth says, this is for my glory. Out of all the voices calling out to me, I will choose to live.
Yes, that is casting crowns.
Okay, good.
I mean, it had the word casting crowns in there.
So. Yeah. That one, I guess it needs to be a little bit more spelled out for me.
A little bit more spelled out to me. Yeah, I specifically chose the King James Version so it wouldn't be so spelled out for you because I thought it'd be too obvious.
No, I don't think I would have gotten them anyway.
Okay.
Like plank eye, I never would have gotten that.
Of plank eye,
no.
You think of plank in another. Because I think PFR, it actually says.
Nope, would
I think
not.
It actually says like a plank in your brother's eye.
Okay. Nope, never would have gotten it.
Okay, Deb.
But that one, yeah.
Yeah, we're on to number 8.
That one was more like in college. Mm-hmm. In the odds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a later group. Mm-hmm. All right, Deb, I think we're on to number 8. This is from Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 through 9.
Okay.
For by grace are ye saved through faith. And that,
I think I know it.
And that not of yourself. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast.
Is it point of grace?
It's point of grace! Yay! Deb, you're back on the horse!
Yay! All right!
Yes.
That was another big one for me.
Mm.
Like, that group.
Mm-hmm. I remember seeing Point of Grace at Hills Alive. Mm-hmm. I was right in the front row. So Hills Alive was this outdoor concert. There's no seating.
Yeah.
People just, walk into the front. So I made my way throughout the night right to the front. And the gal who was singing, I don't know any of the ladies'
names. No, I don't know their names.
But one of them was pregnant.
Oh,
and
yeah.
While she
I
was,
remember that.
Do you remember me
when,
talking
when
about
she
this?
Was.
Oh, okay. But she was singing one of her songs and like touched her stomach while she was singing and forgot her words.
Oh.
And so the whole crowd started singing it. And uh-huh. She's like, thank you so much. Like she just like, I watched it on her face. Like she touches her stomach and like starts to think, I suppose. About,
yeah.
Like, I've got this baby. I don't know.
Yeah. Who this knows?
Armchair psychiatrist about what was going on in her brain, but forgot her words to this, like, one of their major songs. They only did, like, 2 songs.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Just forgot it, and then the crowds joined in, and she, she said thanks. But anyway, it was kind of an interesting experience.
Yeah, that would be. Yeah.
Deb, number 9.
Okay.
This is from Matthew 4:19.
Okay.
And he saith unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men.
Go fish.
Deb, you've got it. Go fish.
All right.
Perfect to me. Because I see you as a child, blameless in my sight. Just spend some time with me and I'll make everything all right. Because you're my little girl. You're the one that I created. And no one in this world could ever be like you. When you're crying in the night, all you need to do is call me. I'll be there for you. you're my little girl.
Yeah, I remember seeing Go Fish in concert in the town that's right next to us here. They came and did like a concert when I was in high school, and I really enjoyed them then. And then they started coming to where we went to college and did a Christmas concert every year at our college.
Yeah, that's why it's so familiar. I tried to think, why do I know them so well? Mm-hmm. And it's because they came to our college every Christmas, and mm-hmm. I went once with you, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. But were they a cappella?
Yeah.
Yeah, acapella. Strictly a cappella.
They're really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really enjoyed them, mm-hmm. and I haven't listened to anything of theirs in a long time.
Break it out, Deb.
15 years.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Good stuff.
They do a rendition of I Love You, Lord, that I really like. It's all
cool.
Yeah.
Huh.
Okay. All right, Deb.
I think I know what the last one's going to be.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Not without a clue. Okay, yep, here we go.
I'm going to throw you for a loop. Arming the answer right now. I'm going
to throw you for a loop.
Oh.
We'll see.
Okay.
All right, Deb, this last one for number 10 is from Isaiah 52:7.
Okay.
Which says, how beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him that bringeth good tidings, that publisheth peace, that bringeth good tidings of good, that publisheth salvation, that saith unto Zion, thy God reigneth. I didn't add any THs. That's all in there. Deb, what group could that be?
Well, I'm just going to say the one I wanted it to be.
All right, you go for the one you want it to be.
I think then I'll have a serious guess.
Okay. Well, let's just throw
the one I wanted it to be was FFH.
Oh, which stands for?
Far From Home.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's like, I could have done that one because that would have been like the verse that's like, as like
this is aliens, not our
and,
home.
Aliens
yeah.
and strangers in
mm-hmm.
a foreign land. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Shoot.
That's okay.
That would have been a good one.
Okay. I don't know. Right, I'm just going to guess Cademan's Call.
I'm going to give you a hint, Deb, because okay. you need all the help you can get. I think this will bring
I
up to
really
50.
Do.
If you can get this, I think you'll bring up to 50% on this quiz. Yeah. So I'm focusing on this first line, and okay. I'm going to read it back. It says, how beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him that bringeth good tidings.
Beautiful feet.
What's another? I'm going to give you another hint.
Okay.
Deb, what's another way to say good tidings? If this wasn't the King
good
James.
News.
Okay. Somebody who brings
good news.
Good news.
Newsboys.
Deb, you pulled it out. You got it. You got half of them right. That's
yes.
the Deb, that was the newsboy.
That was hard.
Yes, that was hard. I just, yeah. But
you know.
Maybe somebody really
You do
it.
You.
All right, Deb.
Mm-hmm.
5 out of 10.
Okay, yeah. Maybe. Are you sure it wasn't 4?
It might have been 4.
Like, it might have been 4.
Let's just say, maybe not the best you've ever done on a My Darling's Distractions quiz.
Absolutely not the best I've ever done.
But maybe not the worst. I can't remember.
Absolutely the worst I've ever done.
Cool. All right, that probably says more. So this is
maybe only did worse with the Survivor quiz.
We've both learned this as teachers. Now, if we had a couple other people take that quiz, mm-hmm. and they would have had a hard time too, then the problem probably is on the quiz maker, not on the, right? Isn't that what they say to teachers? If everybody's failing, it means you didn't teach it right?
Yes. I mean, that's generally the rule that
that's
I go by.
The rule. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Well, Deb, I'm going to pull out another quiz.
Yeah, good. Please.
To give you a chance to redeem yourself, but I don't know if I'm making things any easier for you.
Oh,
So along the lines of a name that tune quiz, as I thought we could
will
do...
Will we get to hear some music?
Yeah, we will get to hear some music. So I thought it would be an opportunity to... So here's the thing. We're going to get to hear some music. I think you're going to be pretty disappointed
in
the way you're going to get to hear this music. So what I thought would be interesting was, is I could do a name that tune, but I figured, name that tune would be so easy for you. So what I did is I went a little crazy here, and this is kind of, I don't know, we'll see how this goes.
Okay.
What I did is I thought, you know, Deb could do a name that tune, but what if I changed the song a little bit? So I would like you to imagine something.
Oh, no.
Put yourself back in the late 80s, early 90s. What's the probably the most popular video game system around?
What? I don't know.
Oh, just think, Deb.
Oh, Atari.
Deb. You're making a fool of yourself in front of everyone, Deb.
At my house, that was the most popular video game system.
Okay, well, let me just help you out. So in the late 80s, early 90s,
SNES.
It was just the regular Nintendo NES. Yes, you got it. Good job, Deb. You got it. Yeah, so I'd like you, Deb, to imagine a world in which...
With Mario.
Yeah, imagine a world in which contemporary Christian music became the soundtracks of your video games. Oh, my
goodness. Is this all going to be in, like, bit... Yes. Bit
sure.
Coin.
Chip tune. Yes, in Bitcoin, Deb. This is all going to be in Bitcoin, the cryptocurrency Bitcoin. No, Deb. So What I've done is I've taken a couple of songs. I've got eight of them here. And I have put them to chiptunes, which means I've taken the components of their song and translated that into only sounds that could have been created by the original Nintendo Entertainment System.
Okay, but these are like legit popular songs. No?
Yeah, no, they are. They are. Yes. This might
are
be
any
tricky.
Of them PFR?
No.
Okay, I don't know them.
PFR.
I would not know those.
None of them are
PFR. Are any of them... Plank Eye.
None of them are Plank Eye.
Are they songs by popular Christian groups or singers?
I think so, yes.
What?
Yeah, no, I think they are.
You think so?
I mean, I'm pretty sure they are.
What was your standard for picking these songs?
I went through a couple of Ranker articles about most popular Christian songs of all time.
Okay.
I also referenced a couple of Wow albums.
Okay, yep.
So Wow would be...
If it's from Wow 1996, I know it.
Okay, so just to clue everybody in is just like you had now, that's what I call music.
Yeah.
Where you would, you know, get the popular music of the year. Wow. Mm-hmm. Was the Christian version of that, where it would play the top Christian music of the year.
Yes.
So, yeah, some of these were on, a number of these were on the Wow That's the 90s or Wow of the 90s album.
Okay. So. All right.
Okay.
Deb, I'm in.
You're in. Come on. Just
I'm in. I'm all in.
Just humor me, Deb.
Nope.
Also, some of these might not. So I had to do, I was a little bit on a time crunch trying to get these done before we got, some of these could stand to be worked on a little more.
You'll do that in the edit.
No, I don't.
No, it's going to be raw what you have now.
It'll be raw. So, everybody can hear what you had to listen to. So, all right, Deb, you are just going to name, I'll give you bonus points. No, I won't give you bonus points. If you can name the artist, you get bragging rights. But just the name of the song.
Name of the song. Okay. Are any of them going to be just like straight up hymns that have been popular
We don't know.
Oh, Deb. Okay. All right.
We'll have to listen.
Are any of them for him?
Deb, you'll have to listen and find out.
All right.
Okay, Deb.
I'm in. I'm all in.
Deb's all in. And at home, see if you can get him as well. All right, Deb. You're sitting down to play your favorite video game. On your Nintendo Entertainment System.
Okay.
And this is the song that you hear.
Okay. To be honest, I'm a little annoyed
Deb,
I know, I'm sorry.
No, it's fine.
But I'm sure that it will be so entertaining
for somebody, apparently.
As we go.
Sure.
I'll get into it.
All right.
It's Awesome God.
By?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Deb, you're correct. That's Awesome God by Rich Mullins.
Oh, Yeah, I probably should have known that.
Yeah, Rich Mullins.
I mean, like, somebody had to write it.
Oh, man. Rich Mullins had a ton.
Yeah, he was like... I don't know.
Prolific.
Whoever writes a lot of the worship songs now, like whoever that is, that was him. Yeah. Like
the Gettys, maybe they write a lot of worship songs.
I don't know.
But all right, good job, Deb. You got the first one.
Okay.
You ready for number two?
Yeah.
I don't know if they get any better.
Sorry, I don't. I think you did a great job, Luke.
Get ready for a lot of bleeps and bloops.
Okay.
Here we go. All right, we're gonna sit down and play this game, Deb.
Is it a Michael W. Smith song?
That's a good question, Dan.
I have heard this song so many times.
Mm.
I know I have.
Okay.
And it really is throwing me off to have it in this.
I wondered.
I wondered.
Yeah. I wondered how the.
But I feel like it's a Michael W. Smith song, so okay. I'm going to guess that for the artist. And. Na, 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 na. Yeah, it's a Michael W. Smith song, but I'm not going to be able to guess the name of it.
Deb, you are correct. It is Michael W. Smith.
I knew it.
The correct answer is Place in This World.
Oh, yes.
I'm looking for a reason. Roaming through the night to find my place in this world. My place in this world. Not a
The other thing that they did is, like, Nintendo music in general was a little bit peppier.
Yeah.
So a lot of the time signatures have been changed.
Yes. That was a good one. Right. Yeah, and I have heard that one a ton.
Mm-hmm.
You threw me off on that one. Yeah. That was a good clue.
All right. Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Deb, number three.
Okay. So good.
That the Nintendo specifically version.
Oh yeah,
is so
that's
good.
It's really bringing it alive for me. That was Jesus Freak by DC Talk.
Deb, you are correct.
Yes. Oh, man, there are so many. Okay, so we have to play bit of each of these songs.
I'll throw in a little clip of what it really sounds like after you get it right.
There's so many good ones that just need to be included.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll probably make a playlist because now I want to.
Yeah, now you have to.
So I'll put it up there.
All right.
I'll link it on
so far,
on the website.
So, yeah, that's right. So far, you are 2 for 3, I think.
I think so.
Yeah. All right, Deb. Question number 4.
Okay. Familiar.
It is. Deb, I'm going to give you a small clue. I'm going to just say the word. lift me up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And I know that should have just given it away. I don't know. I'm going to guess it's the group Audio Adrenaline.
Deb, that is incorrect.
Okay.
I'm going to give it the group.
Oh.
It's Jars of Clay.
Oh, yes.
And the song is?
Flood.
Yes.
Yes.
Deb, Flood by Jars of Clay.
When I'm falling. Yes. Oh, yeah. But if I can swim after 40 days in my mind is crushed by the crashing waves that be up so high that I cannot fall, let me alone. Lift me up when I'm falling. Lift me up we can die. Now I know it.
All right. Okay, Deb.
Mm-hmm.
That's a miss. You're only shooting half. This is another man. Okay. These are tough. Apparently, the more creative I get with these quizzes, the harder they get.
Well, yeah.
All right.
Stands to reason.
Yeah. I just felt like this would be so easy. I had to make them tricky. Deb.
Yes.
Number 5.
Okay. Ah, it's Shine by the Newsboys.
Yeah, you got it, Deb. Shine, make them wonder what you got. Make them wish that they were not on the outside looking for. Shine, let it shine before all men. Let them see good works in men. Let them glorify the Lord.
Such great music.
Yeah, very good.
I mean, are they making music that good anymore?
Yes. Yeah, I would say maybe even better. Yeah. No, yeah, it's that nostalgia. It's that nostalgia drug kicking in, Deb.
Yeah, that's what it is.
To where you were.
Yeah.
Yeah, Shine was like, it was maybe one of the albums that I was most obsessed with when it came out. Like,
mm-hmm.
I just listened to that one. Like, yeah, that one and Free at Last, the DC Talk album, both of those, I really hit those hard.
The DC Talk album that I liked the most was probably their greatest hits one that just had
so many good songs.
Was it called Greatest Hits?
Mm.
I don't know. Maybe like Best Ones or...
Okay.
Anyway, that was a great one.
Yeah. All right, Deb. Nice job. You got that. We're on to number 6. Are you ready?
Oh, no. Okay. Now I'm ready.
Okay. Deb, which song is this?
Like, I feel like I could have sang some of it, but I'm not sure.
Not sure if you can get it.
Mm-mm. The words rain forever are in there somewhere. Oh, wait a second.
Do you need to hear it again?
Is it Twyla Paris?
Deb, it's Twyla Paris.
Yes.
And what's the song? For the point.
I don't know the name of the song.
Oh, no, Deb!
Do I get a point for the artist? No.
I mean, that's
he
like,
says,
that's
not shrugging the, that's his not shoulders.
The game is you're sitting in front of your Nintendo and you're playing the latest hit.
We've heard the premise.
And Twyla Paris has done the soundtrack for it, and this is the song that she's written for you. And the song is called. You might kick yourself.
Yeah, probably. I don't know it.
Deb.
As much as it kills me.
It was Twyla Paris. The correct answer is God is in control.
Oh, yeah. Ugh. And I even like was kind of annoyed by this song because it just kept saying that over and over and over again.
That's one thing. Actually, as I listened back and in prepping this, I had to, you know, take apart the parts of the song.
Yeah.
And specifically the song Shine that we were just bragging on so much has nothing going on. Like they repeat. It's like bam, 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 bam.
Yes.
They just repeat that.
That's over true. And you're
over
right.
And over for 3 minutes of just that little catchy ditty.
Mm-hmm. I do remember that. Now that you said it, there really was not much more.
It really becomes blatantly obvious when you break that song apart and put it into just the notes, put them into MIDI form.
Yeah.
Oh, man. It's just, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Deb.
And that was another song that I felt like dragged on. That Twilight Paris song. Yeah. Anyway, it was still good.
Yeah, still good song. All right, Deb.
Every once in a while.
Number seven.
Okay.
Let's see if you can get the last two here.
There are parts missing.
Mm-hmm. On purpose.
There are parts missing.
I know. I did it on purpose, Deb. If I just put in straight just every note of the song, it'd be like playing it on the piano.
Have you been doing that this whole time?
Yes, I've been doing this whole time.
Luke, that's why I'm not getting them.
But don't you feel like it'd be too obvious if I just put in every note of every song into this?
Probably.
Yeah. I mean, I'm specifically cutting out parts.
Sabotage.
I'm jumping into the middle of songs.
And
I'm leaving out important
notes.
Parts. Yep. I'm just playing little bits of songs. And yeah, there's some notes. I'm leaving out some notes. Yep.
Like a lot of notes. Uh-huh. Like you cut out a huge portion of the lyric on that
for
one.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. Is that fair?
I wanted this to be a challenge.
Okay. That was Where There Is Faith by For Him.
You're right, Deb.
Yeah.
Isn't that great that I made it a challenge, but it was still attainable?
And I earned that one.
Earned that one. It wasn't easy, was it? Okay, Deb, nice job.
Thanks.
That was Where There Is Faith by For Him.
Yep. Yeah, that was a good one. I'm glad there was some For Him on there.
Deb, to find the components of this song. The song, the For Him song, mm-hmm. was very hard to find, by the way.
Really?
I do a lot of searching on GeoCities pages.
Okay.
Because that's the only place I could find the MIDI components, so.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, cool. anyway.
Like GeoCities is old.
Yeah,
like I got
old,
that. Like that's
old website. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so like when you have a MIDI, that's when you've taken a song and broken it up into just basically notes that are it's a MIDI file, but that notes need to be assigned to instruments and things like that.
Oh yeah. Uh-huh.
And all of the ones I found would be like the backup tracks or the accompanying music. And so in this one I found on this GeoCities site had one of the tracks was listed as like Carson Piano. So it's somebody just tinkering the melody. Top of just whatever else is going on. So,
oof.
Okay, good job,
Deep
Deb.
Deep dive.
All right, Deb.
Yeah.
Last one. This one might be really hard.
Okay. So this is number eight.
It's number eight. It's a very simple one. It's very simple sounding, but I will let you know that you can't actually hear the melody. You have to pull this off from like the accompanying part that comes with it.
Oh my.
We'll see how this goes.
Okay.
You ready?
Thank you. Yikes.
Tough, huh? But kind yeah. of familiar, right?
slightly.
All right. So once again, let me give you the hint. This is just an accompanying piece. That would be so.
You would probably hear this
plinked out on a piano mm-hmm. while somebody's doing special music on a Sunday.
Right. And there's no, like, they're not playing the notes that person should sing. Nope, it's just mm-hmm. So is this?
I'll give you a hint.
Okay.
It's a Stephen Curtis Kratman song.
I don't even have any idea. And now I'm trying to rack my brain for the name of one Stephen Curtis Chapman and you're song. Not able to do it. And it's insane and unjustifiable that I can't even think of one.
I've not made your life any easier tonight by throwing all of these bizarre ways to look at Christian music.
It's true. I Place in This World, that's Michael W. Smith. Mm-hmm. The only, I keep thinking of the Stephen Curtis Chapman songs that he sang about dancing with his daughter.
Mm.
That's not it.
Okay.
Is this sped up at all?
It might be just a smidge.
Friends Are Friends Forever is Michael W. Smith.
Okay. I will say you're kind of along the right lines with Friends Are Friends Forever. It's the Stephen Curtis Chapman version of Friends Are Friends Forever.
Ooh.
That should be a huge hint, Deb.
Yeah.
Did you always feel like Stephen Curtis Chapman was in Michael W. Smith's shadow?
No. Okay. It really was a toss-up between the two of them for me. Like, very similar. And they both were huge. Mm-hmm. And Michael W. Smith then really started to do a lot with instrumental. Mm-hmm. And that was really cool. Yeah. But maybe a highlight because of just like the time that this happened. Mm-hmm. I went to a Michael W. Smith / Stephen Curtis Chapman concert. Mm-hmm. And that was really cool because it was after he had that
accident
with his daughter. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that was kind of cool to listen to mm-hmm. him after that. It was a couple years after that had happened.
Yeah.
It's
Stephen Curtis Chapman song. I would say it's the Friends Are Friends Forever.
Is it like one of the marriage songs?
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
It's like one of the songs that they would play at all the weddings.
I bet it would be.
Here For You or I Will Be Here. I Will Be Here?
You got it.
Yes! Yeah.
That took so much work.
It really did.
Yes.
I will be here.
Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here.
I needed a lot of hints on that one. I would not have gotten it.
Am I right, though? Isn't that like the Stephen Curtis Chapman version of the Friends Are Friends Forever song? It's just like...
It's sang a ton.
Laughter turns to crying. All that business.
Uh-huh. It's a good one.
If you listen back through, maybe you'll kind of hear, like, that's definitely the accompanying piece that comes with, like, you can just hear just hints of what the notes should be.
Now that I know what it is.
Yeah. Okay, Deb, fine. You did fine.
Fine.
You did okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was fine.
It was a really fun topic idea.
Yeah, fun topic. Uh-huh. Maybe the implementation of the quiz was a little lackluster.
No, it was fine.
Interesting.
It was fine.
Yeah, it was fine.
It's fine.
So, Deb, quick question. Did we have any artists that we didn't get a chance to talk about that you wanted to give a shout out to?
Oh, FFH.
Mm-hmm.
There was a period of time where I really enjoyed them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
we played them when we, after this is kind of a throwback to last episode,
mm-hmm.
but we played them when we walked down the aisle leaving our wedding ceremony.
Uh-huh. We played that song in our last episode.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Audio Adrenaline.
Yeah. I didn't include them at all, but
there was one of their albums. I don't know which one it was, But I was always reluctant to listen to them because it just didn't feel like something I would like.
Mm, okay.
And then there was a period of time where my cousin moved to town. And so then we were driving every Wednesday night to pick him up to go to church. And he was like, hey, have you guys listened to Audio Adrenaline? No. And so like, maybe it was even his tape. Like we put it in the, and we listened to it so, like nonstop for probably 6 months.
Wow.
Yeah. And let's see. Cademan's Call was a big one in college for me. Jeff Moore in the Distance was the first concert I ever went to.
Okay.
Wow. And yeah, so that was good.
I remember Jeff Moore in the Distance, he played Home Run. Is that right?
Yes.
That was the song my dad coached my Little League team.
Uh-huh.
And he really liked that song.
Okay.
And so I remember he brought all of our team together and brought out a boombox and played the song Home Run by Jeff Moore in the Distance. And just gave a little mini sermon, and then we played the game.
Sounds right. You gotta free and swing. Watch it till it's going, going. It's gone. Oh, 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 oh. We need a home run. Oh, 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 oh. We need a home run. Oh. Prophet, Priest, and King.
No. Yeah.
I think that was a group, right? Small Town Poets.
Small Town Poets, Plum.
Oh, another, well, I never listened to Plum.
Oh, okay.
Another one, Down Here.
Oh, yeah.
I loved that group.
Mm-hmm. Shane and Shane.
Shane and Shane was a great one. Mm-hmm.
A lot of really good ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a whole, you could make a life.
What else did Liz say?
Oh.
What other ones did Liz say?
Let's throw in some other things that Liz said. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Sonic Flood. I just thought of the other band that was really big Sonic when we were Flood. In high school. Sonic Flood. Stephen Curtis Chapman, For Him, Point of Grace, Rebecca St. James.
Oh, yeah. Stacey Orrico.
W. Smith. There's so many. You could get into later times. Jackie with Matthew Velasquez. West. Yeah. Once it gets into the college years for me, it all gets kind of hazy. So, anyway, I shouldn't say hazy. That gives the wrong impression. it gets muddled. I should say that. I kind of forget group names from that era. Bands and artists.
And then again, Liz calls back.
Avalon.
Oh, Avalon.
Sarah Groves. Stacey Orrico, Third Day.
Oh, there it is.
Toby Mac. Nicole C. Mullen.
Sure.
Can I get a witness? Michael Tate. I'll just throw in K-Max because I already said the other two.
That was it?
No, there's no. She calls again.
All right.
Mark Schultz.
Oh, Mark Schultz.
Chris Tomlin.
Yeah.
Acapella.
Oh, yeah.
Goldfish.
Whoa, heyday. Christian music, heyday, yeah. For real.
Yeah. I mean, but we're talking about like 3 decades. But yeah, you're right. A lot of good stuff in those 3 decades.
Well, yeah.
And which is funny because we've kind of, maybe we'll end with this, but it has kind of changed where at the time it wasn't necessarily worship, what you'd call worship
music.
Right.
No, I think that's the difference.
Right. Now, if you listen to anything, which it's kind of transitioned into like worship bands have become kind of the most popular.
And that's when I remember when I was like, do they make music like that anymore? Mm-hmm. I mean, but that's what I mean is that it was all just like for your entertainment. Right. You listen, you learn, and like you hear it on the radio, you buy their albums. Mm-hmm. But like this. You
wouldn't necessarily sing it in church.
No. Right. And this is what we are getting now, I feel like, at least from what my experience is that a lot of it is what you would adopt and hear at like a the service.
Hillsong United and a lot of different things like that. So yeah, and there were a lot of them that didn't get, a lot of them that I would be familiar with that didn't get mentioned by Liz would be maybe a little bit more on the, I don't know if hard side is right, but there were, you know, there are ones like Insiders or Supertones or, just Skillet. Reliant K.
Oh, yeah, Reliant K.
Just, yeah, a lot of those other ones. That
I didn't listen to those as much. Mm-hmm. But I can't believe I didn't mention Sarah Groves.
Right.
Yeah. That was huge, huge. Mm-hmm. And Avalon.
Right. And these are all getting more into, like, the aughts and maybe even the first, the tens. Wow, and I don't know what to call that decade. You don't think 2010s? Okay.
Teens, maybe. Yeah.
So, Deb, we could really... So, everybody, you can be looking out for Deb's Spotify playlist.
Yeah.
That's probably going to be hours long of just couple, 3 decades full of contemporary Christian music for you to listen to. Best place to find that is going to be go out to mydarlingsdistractions.net. That's where our that's where our website is.
Mm-hmm.
And just a heads up, if you are looking out at our SoundCloud feed and you're like, oh, where are all the shows? We've changed and we've moved all of our old episodes past like 3 old. We've moved those all out to mydarlingsdistractions.net. So that's the place you can go out and find all of our stuff. Hey, if you've got an idea for an episode, give us a call.
Yeah, please do.
61 Air 0 Volt. You can leave us a voicemail just like Liz did five times just to get this episode together. Thank you, Liz.
And I'm really thankful for all those suggestions. What a blast from the past.
Yeah.
And if you're like my brother, you will put us into your contact list. Your phone
contacts. Yeah, that's
right. Put My Darling's Distractions into your contacts and then we're on speed dial.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Or you can also email us if you don't feel like hearing your voice over the air. You can email us at mydarlingsdistractions.
We do get a lot of texts too. Do you get texts?
No.
I get some texts.
Sure, yeah. Or you can reach out to Deb.
But I don't always remember to.
Yeah. But if you want to be on the air, the safest way to do that is to put something in the voicemail.
So. Yeah, I do, because it's just more fun.
Yeah. All right, Deb. Well, thanks for coming with me on this blast of our Christian contemporary past.
And Luke, you did a great job.
Thank you. I'm sorry.
I mean, you really put a lot of time into it.
I did. I shouldn't say a lot of time, but a lot of... I tried to be more creative because I felt like, oh, something different.
Well, it was good. It was definitely fun. It was fun.
Definitely different. And who knows? Maybe you did the best out of anybody who's ever listened. So maybe be proud of those 50% you got.
Yeah, I will. All right. I will be. And you be proud of what you've created, Luke. All right.
Thank you.
Yes, I'm affirming.
Yeah, thank you.
Affirming what you've done.
Yeah. All right. Well, that is all the time we have for tonight. So thank you for joining us.
Thanks, everybody.
I've been Luke.
I'm still Deb.
This has been My Darling's Distractions. That was an okay outro.
Sure. Good night.
Take your candle and go light your world. Frustrated brother, see how he's tried to light his own candle some other way. Robbed and lied.